Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager. I retired lecturer in mortality, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Now, let's apply the above principle to the situations in the world. When I wrote this book in 1995, then Lebanon was hot. And over there, they were killing each other and fighting Christian, Muslim and all that. So these fanaticism among the people is least in the people of the West and is the greatest in the people of India, Punjab, or in East. So you will see that people in the East will suffer much more on fanaticism than people of the West. So Middle East is halfway, you know, because the conscience of the people or the tribal instinct will save them if there's any left. So application of the basis of survival, Lebanon. In this country, the people have forgotten their tribal integrity or identity altogether, and they strongly represent themselves in politics in the name of Muslims and Christians. Therefore, destruction of the country shall be great as in the other neighboring countries in the Middle East. So there also, when Gaddafi was attacked, he was asking for Muslim brethren, come join me. He was also not getting the support of his tribal people, but Muslim brothers. So he was asking for the sons of Satan to come and help. Whereas the sons of man, his tribal people, he did not ask him. By instinct, they helped him. Wherever the people have the tribal instincts, they will suffer less. In fact, Lebanon and Sri Lanka will remain the living pictures of hell. Now in Lanka, you know, it used to be Lanka. In the time of Ravan, it was a great law and order. It was a living heaven on earth. Whereas in this dark age, it becomes the opposite. Where there was heaven, it becomes hell. And that time it was known as just Lanka, a secular country. Now it's called Sri Lanka. Sri means spiritual, ecclesiastical, celestial, you know, celestial, very high standard. Sri is the Kursi title of the prophets, Sri Ramchandraji, Sri Krishnabaldevji. Whereas the ordinary men, you know, they are known as Sri Man. So calling Lanka a Sri Lanka is a very great uplift. Spiritual uplift that shows in the spiritual darkness, that is hell, you know, living hell. Israel, this country is almost 100% of the Jews of flesh, and therefore they shall experience a great tribulations after Israel, USA, UK, France. These are the colonies of Jews, because Mammon makes the mere go, etc., which are the pro-USA countries, attack a country making atomic bombs as Iran or any other country in the world or any country in the pro-Russia group of countries. So there will be split between pro-America and pro-Russia. After the attack, most countries would start killing Jews in the same fashion as they did in 64 AD. The 2 years after the last honest and righteous person like Lot, you know, who left Sodom and Gomorrah. So this person was in the name of James the Just. He was killed by the Jews. And there were no just men left then in Jerusalem, where the people could go and address their grievances. So people were cheating, fleecing. They had made the Israel or the Jerusalem a Sodom and Gomorrah. This will also be followed by the economic crisis all over the world, in which the rich and greedy would be killed by the poor that they have fleeced. This will be in accordance with the saying, in a house there are five. Three of once born simpletons against two of clever, twice born people of mind, are evil spirited, greedy people. So the house is our physical body. Remember the five husbands of the Samaritan woman? They are related to this five, you know. And they are of ego and of mind. So of ego there are three, and of the mind there are two. Mind is greed and worldly temptation. Ego is the ego of your tribal seed, ego of your prowess or your strength, you know, like a footballer or a cricket player, or even if you want to talk to them, they say, hey, we know better than you because we earn more money. And the third ego is of the knowledge of the books, or religious knowledge, which you can have by books, which the once-born people acquire, while the twice-born people of spirit acquire the religious knowledge in spirit, as the Samaritan woman at the well had. That is why she engaged Christ Jesus in deep discussion, even surprised his laborers. But these Jewish people, they hate the Samaritans, and they painted a very wrong picture, as the men of letters could do. So they will fight with each other, as during the Holocaust. The main cause of the Holocaust was also that the clever people became rich, and the honest people who are clean-hearted, they were fleeced. And so the money was accumulated by the rich, and so this, you can see what led to Holocaust. There was the other region because of this, the German, when they became German, wheat plants, they always killed the tares. When English were English, they had Holocaust too. So only safe haven was USA, where there was no specific tribal majority. In fact, the seeds of Isaac being the chosen people of God, it is through them that God gives us practical instructions in his will. Further, this sequence of events leading to great tribulations are predictable in that if by the end of this year, as per the Mayan calendar, if a country making the atomic bombs is attacked, like Iran, you know, or any other, then it will take two more years to bundle up the tares in Israel before the final atomic war around end of 2014 or 15. The Jews shall maltreat the Palestinian far worse, and that would infuriate most countries. Palestinians may be expelled from their homes, and Israel may also expand its territory to the boundaries of Promised Land, because Promised Land belonged to the sons of Abraham, sons of Isaac. And this time they are being bundled up for final burning. During Moses, when he brought them up, he made them sons of Abraham faithful. They made them tribal people, not spiritual, religious people outwardly. They were Jews inwardly then. Then they had a promised land, lush green. And now they are living there. They will have enough to live so that they could be bundled up. Not all the Jews being the tares, merciful people in the manners of Lot will be saved as Lot was saved from the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah. Remember that in any tribe or anything, you know, everybody is not bad one. There are good people also, but their number is very little. So the majority counts, and so when I say these people Jews, then it's the majority. Jews are flesh. Afghanistan. This country is also in the limelight, and the people have a strong tribal integrity. This tribal integrity will save them from complete ruin. Now these Taliban and other people have come, but still they have a strong tribal integrity, and that they can be saved. Like in Africa, you know, some Dar es Salaam, there is not much sectarian riots, because there the tribal integrity is strong. In Ghana, where we lived 14 years, we found tribal marks on their faces, which identify them. In fact, in the past, the Afghans invaded less strong countries like India, and now they are supposed to bear the fruit of their past deeds of looting and killing. In this dark age, you know, you do things at one time and you reap the reward quick. It doesn't take much time. So these Afghans, they used to raid India and kill people and loot them. And they were not contented people. So they will bear the fruit of that looting. Only the merciful Afghans shall survive the tribulations. India and Pakistan. These two countries are basically of the same tribal people. And they will have tribulations right to 2014-15, when the third atomic war is expected. Tribulation will be much concentrated in the Punjab, where from I come, where the holiest of holy temple in the name of Golden Temple is also there in Amritsar. Remember that the holiest of holy temple in Amritsar is a spiritual hospital for the spiritually sick people, the cheat, the greedy people. There shall be much tribulations in this area than say in Haryana or Peshawar or in the South India. You know, they will be living in peace. The order of tribulations being governed by the saying of Sadguru Nanak Dev Ji, Biyo Bij Pat Lagai, Ab Kyon Ugve Dal. That is that those people who haven't forgotten their tribal integrity, they will have their honor intact, that they will live peacefully. By 2014, or 15, states like the Punjab shall have no law and order, and there shall be a great war between India and Pakistan. So when that takes place, then you will see how they will be destroyed. That will maybe leading to atomic war, you know. Western world, they are mostly the nations that are led by the psychic politicians who hypocritically proclaim Jesus to be their Lord and God, but lose no chance in selling their weapons to the poor of the third world countries. Go and kill yourself, but give us your money. So they are Mammon worshippers, you know. They supply the arms by the right hand and bread by the left. Most of them, being the Mammon worshippers, have no conscience, never mind the love and service of Jesus in their bloods. They shall perish by their own atomic arsenal in 2014-15, when the third judgment war will take place, in which the beast, sons of Satan, will be locked in the bottomless pit for 1,000 years. From the year 2020 to 2050, the remaining merciless people shall be weeded out, and then we should expect the same situation as the apostles experienced at the Pentecost. Then the money shall have no value or importance, and as Mammon is the root of all evils and chaos, there will be perfect peace. Finally, one should not forget the spirit of man knows only the things of men, and to err is human. Therefore, the above predictions should not be taken for granted, but they are presented in good faith to warn people of the coming events, whose shadows have been studied by me in the light of holy books. If I had possessed the very spirit of God, as the apostles did, then I could have given you the precise times and dates of the events. So 1 Corinthians 2:11, for what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of man which is in him? Spirit of man is a common sense. Even so, the things of God knoweth no man, but the spirit of God, which is Holy Spirit with capital S. Mammon creates hatred, Jesus generates divine love, agape. Study the past to forecast the future. God blesses people according to their conscience, and we call it niyat. So hope this will give you a good idea now about why there's going to be two attacks, you know, the Satan, and the third is the judgment attack. And this is based upon this Trinity, as I explained earlier, that this Trinity document is very good. There you have the once upon people who are simpleton, who could be easily misled, as during attack on Iraq, they said Iraq has weapons of mass destruction. They were not found there. So before even the investigators could report, they started attacking Iraq. So that was the, because Iraq was pointing gun at Israel. So it was the Jewish masters who asked their servants, USA and UK and France and other countries, to go and destroy that country, and they did it. So that was the first attack. Now this was done under ignorance. Then when your person is twice born, then he does so under spirit. So when our royal king Gobind Singh Ji used to fight, he will ask the aggressor, fighter, you know, first you have the attack. So aggressor will attack one first attack. He will say, no, it's not a good one, have another one. So when he will have the second one, because he did it knowingly, then royal king gave the judgment attack, and he will kill the person. So this is the first unknowingly. This is knowingly. That's why those people who are making atomic bomb country like Iran or somebody else, everybody will know that they are making atomic bomb. They shall be, there will be no hidden anything. But these countries, USA, UK, France and other countries where the Jewish lobby is strong, they will attack those countries. Russia would defend them, you know, as they are defending Syria now. And they will do the same thing in to the other countries. So this, there will be split between pro-USA and pro-Russia. And then there will be the judgment war, which should take another 2 years from the attack when it will be done on a country making atomic bomb. So that will be the finish of the age, end of the world, and people in Brazil and other countries where they have the tribal integrity and they don't tell lies, they are true to God, and they will then survive and spread the humanity again as we are presently are. So this cycle of ages, there are swastika, you remember, has four cycles of ages, as I told you in the previous videos. So this cycle of ages will repeat again. Again we have destruction. And according to some of the prediction, it is 103 cycle or something, but we can't say anything because we don't know. They are just, you know, written in the books, and they are just guesswork because human beings have been for many, many years, millions of years or so, you know. This Darwin theory and all that is a nonsense. Because I go to Oxford University, over there they were discussing the Darwin theory in theological seminar. So I told them, human person is there in front of you and you are flogging the dead horse. And when I call them super donkeys carrying holy books, then they get annoyed. So in Jesus, the present count. That's why Jesus, when he was in Jerusalem, they were reading Torah, Jesus Christ will come in the house of David and all that. Jesus said, what about the one standing in front of you? Same, you know, the Darwin theory, man is born of monkey and all that. What about the man standing in front of you? So, our Father God blesses you.